Warning. Some of the reagents shown in this video are harmful, so I recommend you read the material safety datasheet and follow appropriate precautions. Welcome back to the lab. In the last video, I left you guessing what is this material that exhibits yellow fluorescence under ultraviolet light. My original plan was just to post an answer in the comments, but later on I decided to make a short video on it. But first, here's what it is. The material's name is tetranuclear copper 1 pyridine iodide cluster. It is a coordination complex of copper iodide with pyridine. I first read about this complex on this website, which also explains how to make it, so in this video I'll just be following this procedure. Despite the complicated chemical structure, this complex is easy to make if you have the right reagents, but the problem was I didn't have them. In particular, I didn't have pyridine, neither copper iodide. As for pyridine, there's already plenty of videos on how to make it. I do have the footage of the pyridine synthesis, but I feel it's kinda redundant. Let me know in the comments if you want a video on it anyway. Coming to copper iodide, it is best prepared from a more common copper compound, such as copper sulfate, so we'll start with making it. To prepare copper iodide, you'll need copper sulfate, potassium iodide, anhydrous sodium sulfite, and sulfuric acid. Dissolve 1 gram of sodium sulfite in 15 ml of water, and add half a milliliter of 95% sulfuric acid. Use your fume hood, as some sulfur dioxide may be released. In another beaker, dissolve 2.5 grams of copper sulfate in 20 ml of water. Stir, as it takes time to dissolve. Once dissolved, add the sulfate solution. Finally, dissolve 1.7 grams of potassium iodide in 5 ml of water and add it to the other solution. A precipitate of copper iodide will form. Continue stirring to complete the reaction. What happens is that first, sodium sulfite reacts with sulfuric acid to form sulfur dioxide, which remains dissolved in water. Then, the following reaction takes place, where the copper 2 ions are reduced to copper 1 by the sulfur dioxide, and the copper iodide is formed. The copper iodide can be separated from the mixture by filtration and dried on the hot plate. Once we have our copper iodide, it's time to get back to making the fluorescent pyridine complex. To prepare it, you'll need copper iodide, potassium iodide, pyridine, and acetone. First of all, weigh out 0.2 grams of copper iodide and 0.3 grams of potassium iodide. Place both in a beaker and dissolve them in around 1 milliliter of water. Get a test tube and add 0.8 ml of acetone and 0.2 ml of pyridine. Now that we have prepared these two solutions, the synthesis is as easy as pouring one into the other. Stir the mixture for a while to ensure the reaction goes to completion. Then, filter the solid precipitate and wash it with water. Place the filter paper on a warm hot plate and let it dry slowly. It should be noted that the material is fluorescent, but not phosphorescent, so there is no afterglow and cannot be used for glow-in-the-dark applications. A quick note while editing the video. When searching for YouTube channels who made pyridine, I found this channel, Hydrazine Labs, that not only made pyridine, but also the same fluorescent complex shown in this video. You may want to check out his video as well if you found mine interesting.